So we're here for Visual Studio tips and tricks to boost your productivity. My name is John, and I work at Microsoft as a program manager on Visual Studio tools for Unity. One of my favorite parts of my job is that I get to talk to developers like yourselves. And so what I've done is I've compiled a list of tips and tricks that I've learned from those conversations. Some of it's going to seem obvious, but I was a little surprised to learn that there are some simple things that I can share that will help boost your productivity in Visual Studio. Developers just weren't aware of these things. So some of it's we can do a better job making it serviceable, and then I'm going to share that with you now. And then I would love your feedback afterwards if it's useful or not. So let me start just real quickly about what we're doing at GDC. This week we announced Microsoft Game Stack. And what that does, it brings together all of our tools and services to make it easily discoverable for you to create and operate games. So we have a lot of information about that over at the Microsoft booth, which is over that way. So we'd love for you to stop by and ask any questions you have about that. We also have Visual Studio 2019 coming out very soon, and it's available right now in preview. Yesterday, some developers stopped by and asked me, why should I update to Visual Studio 2019? And that's a great question. So when I thought about that a little bit, I thought the main theme of 2019 is a lot of quality of life improvements. So what we've been focusing on is performance and optimizations, better coloration for visualizations, and also better searching. Just all the little paper cuts that you might experience in previous versions, we've been really focused on improving those things. So if you're into making sure that you're the most productive developer, Visual Studio 2019 is a great thing to try. Another thing on the Mac side for Visual Studio 2019 is that we've been getting feedback from developers that the editor experience has not been great, or some quirks, or it's slow to respond. So we've been slowly bringing core components of Visual Studio on Windows, which developers give us lots of good feedback about. We've been bringing those core components over to Visual Studio for Mac. So one of the cool things I'm excited about is in Visual Studio for Mac 8, which is the 2019 version, we have been bringing over the editor from Visual Studio for Windows, which you can try now if you download Visual Studio for Mac 2019, and then it's an opt-in feature. So if you want to stick with the existing editor, that's fine. If you want to opt into the new editor experience, which will give you all the native support that Mac has to offer, you'll get better animations, and it's just smoother. It's really nice to use, so we love your feedback on that. So you can definitely check that out. And that will work with Unity 2018.3 and higher. One of the first things that I usually talk to Unity developers about is, why do you use Visual Studio, and what features do you love about it? I was surprised to learn that a lot of Unity developers that I spoke with felt that Visual Studio was mostly just a text editor for them. And I was like, wow, there's so much more that Visual Studio can do. So I highlighted a couple features here that are in Visual Studio that are generic for every project, not just Unity projects, that I found helpful. So I just wanted to highlight those if you're unfamiliar with them. So we have lots of refactoring support that's useful for just writing C# code in general. Quick navigations between your projects and your code. There's lots of support for the editor just to make it more optimized for you and to do things like duplicate lines and just quickly edit code. We have ways to make sure that code is consistent across your entire team, making sure that all the curly braces are the right way and variable names are exactly the way that your team wants, so everybody's consistent with editor config files. And you can synchronize all those settings between devices too. And then of course we have some customizations for how you want to customize screen layouts, so you can make the editor exactly how you want and personalize it. So those are a couple just general features that Visual Studio has that I think are useful for all Unity developers. And then we also have specific features for Unity developers that we bundle in what we call Visual Studio Tools for Unity. This is what gives you the debugger support that you're used to or learning about. This is what gives you an IntelliSense support for the Unity API methods. This is what gives you Unity Project Explorer, which I'll highlight, attach and play, and you can quickly browse the Unity documentation directly inside Visual Studio. So these are the specific features that we have for Unity developers right now, and we love hearing your feedback about what you need, and that's part of my job, so I would love for you to share that with me so we can continue to build this list out. So let me jump right into my tips. Tip number one is going to sound obvious, but I was surprised at how many developers don't take this advice, and that's get the latest optimizations through Visual Studio updates. The reason that this is important is that we're constantly focusing on performance and making sure that the IDE loads as quickly as possible for you. And with the Unity workflow, switching back and forth between Unity and Visual Studio whenever you have to do script changes, any delay you have there is super painful, and that's the feedback we get. So in Visual Studio 2017, for example, in 15.8.2, we noticed that some developers, or 15.8.1, we noticed some developers were getting 20-second delays when they were synchronizing large projects. That's a huge delay. That's time wasted, and if you have to go back and forth a lot, that's a big performance penalty. So we optimized that down to 9 seconds in 15.8.2. And if you didn't make that update, then you didn't get that 2x performance increase. So that's why just making sure that you're up to date is useful for you in Visual Studio. We also continue to improve that in 2019. And the latest performance improvements we have, we've been iterating on this to make this type of loading solutions, loading projects, starting the IDE as fast as possible. 2019 is getting most of those now. Tip number two, save time by leaving Visual Studio open. Again, this sounds super obvious, but I learned from developers that they might create a script in Visual Studio or in Unity Editor, and then jump over to Visual Studio, make their changes, and then shut Visual Studio down and go back to Unity, thinking maybe they don't have to go back into Visual Studio for a while. But every time you do that, then Visual Studio has to cold start, which is a performance penalty there. It's quicker to just leave Visual Studio open and then go back and forth by double-clicking on your scripts or just go back to Unity, and we'll automatically sync those changes for you. So you don't have to close Visual Studio. So that saves you time. Tip number three, quickly access the Unity API documentation with this keyboard shortcut. Now, I got some feedback yesterday that, okay, I don't have time to remember this keyboard shortcut. That's duly noted, so I'm going to work on making that a little nicer. But this is what it is today. What that lets you do is you can highlight any Unity API method in your mono behaviors and hit this keyboard shortcut, and it will search locally for documentation. When you install Unity, you can download all the documentation. It'll search locally for the documentation and bring it up, and if not, it'll do a web search, and it can do it directly inside Visual Studio. So what that means is you don't have to swap back to your browser, do a web search, look for the API, and then switch back to Visual Studio. So I found this super useful when I'm learning an API or I forget to do something like, why is a trigger not working, and I forgot rigid body or something like that. So this saves you a little bit of time being able to stay in the IDE and jump right back into your code as quickly as possible. Tip number four, you can easily identify Unity API methods with custom fonts and colors. So I posted this on Twitter a little while ago, and I was a little surprised at how many people found it useful, and I thought it was useful, so I thought I'd share it with you. In your fonts and color setting, there's an item called Unity Messages. So any mono behavior method can be customized in color and font choice. And the feedback I got was that it's useful if you're scanning a mono behavior and you have tons of your own methods and tons of Unity methods. You can quickly see which mono behavior methods are from Unity and which are your custom codes. So you can see in this screenshot here, I have all of the Unity API methods like awake and fixed update. I have those set to purple. That's my preference. So I know that those are the methods that Unity's calling, and they're not my custom methods. Where you can see at the bottom, the move method is like my standard color, so I know that's my own code. So it makes it a little easier to navigate your code and quickly find things. Tip number five, you can navigate code with ease using Unity Project Explorer. So if you're already familiar with Visual Studio, you're probably familiar with the Solution Explorer, which is on a picture on the right. But with Unity Project, since all of that stuff's dynamically generated, it gets a little bit messy for how you want to view your code hierarchy. So we have a specific explorer called the Unity Project Explorer, which maps your code files exactly the same as what the Unity Editor shows. So your assets folder that shows all your folders and scripts, we map that one-to-one inside the Unity Project Explorer. And you can get that through the View Unity Project Explorer menu or hit this keyboard shortcut. And I think that makes it a little nicer when you're switching back and forth between Unity and Visual Studio. You can easily know, like, okay, maybe I want to jump to this specific script. You'll know exactly what folder it's in, not have to navigate through the solution and these dynamically generated C# project files. So it just makes it a little quicker to jump back and forth. Tip six, speed up iteration with attach and play. By default, you can attach the Unity Editor by using the play button at the top, but we actually have a little drop-down menu that lets you do attach and play. So what that means is normal workflow is that you need to attach the debugger from Visual Studio to Unity, switch back to Unity, hit the play button, switch back to Visual Studio, and continue your debug workflow. We can do all that in one step with attach and play. So we'll attach the Visual Studio to the Unity Editor and hit the play button for you so you can stay in the IDE and continue your workflow without having to be interrupted by all these switching back and forth. So it's just like a one-step solution there. So I think that's kind of nice. Save you a little bit of time. Tip 7, approve and personalize IntelliSense with IntelliCode. So we're doing a demo of this over at the Visual Studio area of the Microsoft booth, but we have a new extension in 2017, and in 2019 it'll be included in the IDE. But you can use machine learning to train IntelliSense using IntelliCode to give you better suggestions for Unity. So, I mean, IntelliSense is like the number one thing I hear that people benefit from using an IDE with Unity, and that makes sense. That's why we use IDEs. So making these suggestions at the top of the list using machine learning based on your code is what IntelliCode can do. By default, we just released yesterday that IntelliCode will know about the Unity API, so it'll give you suggestions about Unity API methods. But let's say you have your own code, your own libraries, and your own way of doing things. You can train IntelliCode on your own project, so you'll get suggestions based on how your coding patterns are. And you can do all that with custom, what we call custom model training. That takes a few seconds to do. And if you have more questions about that, stop by and, you know, talk to us at the Visual Studio booth. We'll show you how it works. Tip number 8 is you can solve problems faster with Visual Studio Live Share. So we have real-time collaboration between Visual Studio editors using Live Share. So what this means is you can say, you know what, I'm having a problem, I need my buddy to help me debug this. So send them a link using Live Share and it'll open Visual Studio, open the same code you're looking at. They don't even need to download a code a separate way or set up Unity. And then they can see your cursor and they can see what you're doing, and also you can see what they're doing. So think like online documentation editing where everyone can see what each other's doing collaboratively. That's what Visual Studio Live Share is doing. You can see in this animation, I send a link to my buddy Matt, and Matt joins the Live Share, and now he can see the same code as I'm looking at, and you'll see his cursor start bouncing around, and I'm like, hey Matt, you know, I'm having a problem. So he sets a breakpoint, and he can start a debug session, and we can step through the code together, and I don't need to send him anything other than a link for Live Share. So in 2017, that's an extension, and in 2019, that'll be part of the IDE. And we're also demoing that at the Microsoft booth. So I think that's super useful. Tip number 9, you can influence how we evolve Visual Studio by sharing your feedback. Again, it's super obvious, but as I was talking to people that come over and say, hey, I'd really like to see this in Visual Studio, tell us. And do that by going to help, suggest a feature, report a problem if you're having a bug, or suggest a feature if you have something new you'd like to see. What that does, it opens up developer community, and you can post whatever's going on, and then people can vote for it if they have the same problem. We actually do look at that. We look at that just about every day, if not multiple times a day. And the more votes that it gets, it makes a difference. So it's super important if you have suggestions or issues, report them here. This is how we shape the product. This is how we develop. And if you can also reach out to us on Twitter. We're super responsive there. You know, we love hearing your feedback. It really makes a difference. Here's a quick glance at what the future may look like for Visual Studio tools for Unity. So based on the feedback that we've had from developers, these are the areas that we're investigating. So if any of this looks interesting to you, we'd love to hear it. If there's something up here that you, or something that's not up here that you'd like to see, I also want to hear about that. So we have the idea for support for NuGet packages. We've heard from developers they want to use the ecosystem of NuGet, and with the .NET standard support that Unity has in 2018.3, that's a big possibility. So if that sounds interesting to you, let us know. Improved shader support, Unity-specific code analyzers. So Visual Studio does a great job of giving you suggestions for C# projects, but we want to make things that are specific to Unity coding patterns that the IDE can do, and so we're looking into that. And that's it. So I'd love to have any questions, and Christopher will come around with the microphone if you have any questions, and if not, I'll be at the Visual Studio area of the Microsoft booth and love to talk with you. So thank you.